What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Life of a Board Gamer. My name is Daniel, and today we are going to take a closer look at a game called Rollcade. It is a little train game, and I think this is the smallest box that I had ever had pleasure to reviewing. It's like super tiny, but it holds so much. So let's get down to the table and let me show you what's inside here. So let's check out what this cute little box holds in. And it is kind of hard to open it up sometimes because there's really not that many components in it. And over here we have rules, and as you can see, these are like super short rules, but so much game in it. What you also get is you get this one locomotive, the Rollcade, that will go around these cards that I'll show you in a minute. You get four dice that you will be rolling almost constantly throughout the game. Not almost, you will. And there's a whole bunch of different rule books in different languages. And over here you have just a quick reference card, so you know what kind of connections you can do and how many of each card is there in a game of Rollcade. And basically everything revolves around these cards, and you will be playing these cards on the table and trying to move this train and trying not to get so many cards in your discard pile, because everything that is left at the end of the game in your discard pile is negative points. And so yeah, you will start the game. Let me just quickly show you how the game works. So you will just start the game. Oh my god, all the number threes. This is like super weird. And yeah, you will start the game like this, and the locomotive will go in this way. You will start with two cards, and then you will draw the third one, and then you will decide what you want to play. Now the rule is one can never go after the three, but can go after the one, two, or four, because these cards go from number one to number four. So in this case, I can either play this number three, or I can say pass, for example, and then I'll have to pick this one and keep it in my discard pile, and this will be the negative points at the end of the game. But luckily, I have this three, so I will play it like so, and then I will throw three dice because I played number three. And how many of these three dice are showing these locomotive wheel symbol, I'll have to move locomotive that many spaces. And for example, I'll have to move him just one, and that is that. But if the situation was like this, and let's say I rolled these dice and I rolled two, let's say I rolled three, just so I can show you how the game works, what's the beauty of this game. So I have to move it one, and since there is no more cards over here, I have to pick the last two cards because I rolled these three. So I pick these two, and these go in my discard pile any way I want. But since they are both the same number, I can discard them, and so I don't have anything in my discard pile, so I put them back in a box. And the game ends until you go through all these cards, and as I already told you, the beauty of it is you really want to get the cards, to match them with your discard pile, so you can discard those cards from your discard pile, which sounds super weird, but I hope you understand it. I'm really like super bad at explaining the rules of the game in English. I just want to show you the components and quickly try to describe you how the game works. So yeah, that is basically that. That's everything that comes in this little box, but it is so much. Okay, so that was Rollcade. As I told you, it is like the smallest game. It's just deck of cards, one train, four dice, and quick little rules. As you saw, it's like one page, even if that, of the rules. And it is a super easy game to teach, super easy game to learn. You can play it with new people, you can play it with old school gamers, and it offers so much strategy in a so little game. In a so little footprint of a game. I mean, look at this box, this is like super tiny. As you saw, there is that little wooden train. If after the end of this review, if you end up liking this game, definitely go and see if you can get your hands on a deluxe edition, because it comes with a metal train, and it is in a scale of 1/87 scale of the real train, this one, Rollcade.
And that one looks super, super awesome. Unfortunately, I was able to get this one. But, I mean, it is not unfortunate. It is what it is. But I always like when my games are pimped up to the maximum. So I just might buy some little train to stick it in there and make it look like this one, for example. Who knows? Either way, the gameplay itself, it is super fun. It's super engaging. This game, as more as you play it, you start to reveal more how it works. And it is just brilliant how this game works. I mean, basically, you don't want a friend of mine played constantly worrying that he will go too much with the train, and that way the you have to take the cards in your discard pile, and your discard pile is actually your negative points at the end of the game. So you want to try to have as little in your discard pile cards as you can possibly have. And then there is this strategy when you have to put your cards in a discard pile and you cannot touch it. But once, when you pick up a card, if the number matches the card on the top of your discard pile, you can discard both of them. So that is like super genius, because sometimes you are just watching the table and you're trying to derail train on purpose. You are trying to play as many dice as you can, so you know you have, like, for example, 4-3-1-1. And the cards that you are picking up, if you go 4 over the limit, is 4-3-1-1. So basically, instead of you having a discard of 8 cards, you will have 4 cards less in your discard pile. I know it sounds a little bit confusing. I'm not very good at explaining the rules of the game, at least in English. But the game is so brilliant. The tactic, how you want to play this game. Do you want to go and grab as many cards and then try to get rid of them and just play big cards? Or you want to save yourself and play small cards all the time? I mean, if the luck of the draw gives you small cards, of course. But overall, I had so much fun in so little, such a little box that can offer so much strategy. And I don't know. It is super interesting. It is really not that expensive. It is super tiny box. Everything about this game is super. So yeah, definitely. If you like train games, sort of, because this is, after all, a train that is going on, but you don't like heavy train games, you like more of these kind of strategic, but on the light side of the strategic games, definitely check Rollcate. I liked it really much, and it's definitely staying in my collection. So yeah, that is that. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being here. Check out some of my other videos, and please don't forget to subscribe. Check out my Patreon. Do whatever you wish around this channel. This channel is not just mine, it's yours. Everyone owns this channel, if you ask me. So that is that. Until next time. Pozdrav, buddy, and welcome to the life. I don't know. It is a train game, a push your like, deck your back, push your walk. What are they trying to say, man? Concentrate. I'm bad with the stories, with explaining you what is the game about. I'll show you on a table, so let's get down, man.
This video was brought to you by Philibertnet.com, the game in all its states.